cards everybody is doing today. You have before you three different cards representing three different tarot decks for the lovers. Today's question that we're asking is love of my dreams. It's a love reading. It's like love of my dreams, whether it's soulmate or twin flame. That's the question that we're asking for today. And right here you have, like I said, three different cards representing three different groups. We have the lovers from the divine tarot deck. The lovers from the Light Seers tarot deck, and then the lovers from the Gilded Royale tarot deck. Okay, so just want you to take your time. Meditate. If you want to pause the video, you can. Meditate on which group, group one, group two, group three. I probably put the numbers up here that you can see which one you want to choose. So with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and move to group number one. See you there. All right, group number one, we have the lovers here. And like I said, this is from the Tarot of the Divine Tarot deck. And we're going to start with the overall energy of your love of your dreams, whether it's a soulmate, twin flame. You know, there's so many different names that people go with. I like soulmate, but, you know, whichever, to each his own. All right. Like I said, we're going to start with the Oracle of Seven Energies and see how the overall energy for group number one will be. And then we will dive in some more after that and continue with some more cards. All right. There'll be no reversals. There'll be no reversals with this reading. Everything will be read upright and accordingly. And we'll just see and go from there. All right. Let's get one more. Best to make card, but we're going to take the top card right here because it came up here at the top. All right, we have from the Oracles of the Seven Energies, we have Great and Full and Roots of Abundance. Okay, so what this is telling me, this is kind of like the Ace of Cups energy that I'm feeling right here. And when you see like the Ace of Cups energy, it's like full and what? Abundant. So with group number one, I feel that the love of your dream, like soulmate, twin flame energy, that it's going to be a great and abundant love and relationship, okay? That means that, you know, our relationships have its ups and downs, but for the most part, it's going to be very abundant with love, probably finances, however way you want to say it. But that's a great start off with group number one, is that it's going to be, I feel, it's going to be very abundant, wrenching love, happiness, smiles, giggles, you know, everything like that. So that's good so far, group number one, that you have great and full and roots of abundance. All right. So now I'm going to follow up with a tarot card from the Modern Witch tarot deck. Okay. And we're going to say Nine of Cups and Two of Swords. I'm going to get one more card. Okay. And we have Eight of Swords. All right. Now, what this is right here, this is not saying anything weird or gonzo, okay? So, what it's just saying, like, with the Two of Swords, I feel that, you know how, like, when you say, okay, when you're coming into a relationship, you're coming in with, the way I'm seeing, with blind faith, okay? And that sometimes, with some people, we might have that baggage from a relationship, previous relationships that didn't go far. But with this relationship that I'm seeing right here with group number one, I'm seeing that it's going to be a wish fulfillment. You're at Nine of Cups. You got one more cup to go and you'll be in that rainbow that you see with the Ten of Cups. So I feel that's what I'm saying with these roots of abundance and great and full, and with this cup energy right here, that this relationship again is just reiterating how good it's going to be. And that right here just showing that things of the past that, you know, you're coming in with blind trust, blind faith, okay? And that just don't let old relationships and old habits and things, and that's with anybody, okay, you know, get in the way and that make you feel bound in relationship, because it's going to be great and abundant. So don't let the past things, you know, try to carry all this on you, okay? Let it be that you're going in with blind faith, blind trust, and, you know, with that, and that you'll have your Nine of Cups because of the great and full and the roots of abundance. All right, group number one. All right, now let's follow with my, I'm going to put these cards right here for now. Let's go with my Starseed Oracle deck for group number one. And let's see what they say about your love of your dreams. So like I said, so mate, twin flame, whichever way you want to label it. All right. Okay. We're going to take, I know it's a lot of cards, but we're going to go for it. All right. It says, Star Family, you are part of a team of souls calling support. So what I'm seeing right here, that this is like a soulmate connection. Okay, that's what I'm saying when it says team of souls. It's where it says a star family. So it's kind of like one of the things that you were destined to be, like a soulmate. You are not alone. It's saying isolation, physical connection, community. You are not alone, because with this person, whether, like I said, with twin flame or soulmate, so then the universe letting you know that you are not alone. Like that song, you are not alone. Surrender to the sweetness, Venus energy, pleasure, joy, make love to life. Okay, so this is what's telling me right here, that that's what it's saying with that roots of abundance and with that great and full, that your love and saying make love to life, and that just reiterating that group number one, that this is a great relationship coming in. All right, then we have portal, doors are opening, you decide, rewards, wild card. Again, I mean, how many times must tell you, group number one, that is saying that this relationship is, like I said, whether soulmate, twin, however you want to name it, that it's like a door opening for you. Like it says, portal, and it's the rewards that you've been waiting for. Then we have messenger, Seers energy, bringing harmony and balance. And this is what I'm saying right here, that with the relationship that you've had before, that now you will have the balance. That's what I was saying right here with this Eight of Swords energy, that don't let the things in the past that bogged you down with old relationships, because now with this new relationship that's coming in, is bringing in harmony and balance into these new relationships. Okay, group number one. All right, let's follow with my Moonology Oracle deck. Like I said, there's no reversals. Alright. Okay. And excuse me if you hear me like sniffle a little bit. The temperatures keep changing here, so it's kind of like 1 minute's hot, 1 minute cold. Okay, we'll take this one. Hold on. Moonology. Okay. Cards are always flying with me. All right, we have community. I knew this card was going to come out. I knew it when I saw it earlier. Communication is key. New moon in Gemini. And with me being a Gemini myself, we love to talk. So communication is key, group number one. That's what it's saying right here. It's time to take action. Okay, it's same with relationships, that, you know, go for it. Don't let things hold you back. A new start is coming. I keep saying, look, roots of abundance, great and full, that this relationship is coming in. The answers you need are coming. With the relationship, what you've been looking for is coming towards you. It says full moon in Gemini. And like I said, Gemini again. Okay, it says emotions are running high. I mean, it's just telling you everything, that with your emotions, with the relationship, that everything is going to come in like daisies and sunflowers. The energy is gaining momentum. Okay, again, is this all positivity of telling you, with the abundance and with the great and full energy that you're getting with group number one, with this relationship, that this love, that your soulmate, twin flame energy of your dreams is coming in really, really good. All right, so now let's follow with I haven't used this oracle deck. I've used it. It was new. It was given to me as a Christmas present. So we're going to use this is the Mystical Wisdom card oracle deck. I love this deck. I don't want to bend it too much, so let's do it this way. But let's see what they have to say about group number one and love of my dreams. Okay, soulmate, twin flame. I'm going to get one more. And I think I'm going to get this one right here. All right, like I said, new beginnings. Begin your new life. I just said that right here where it says emotions are running high. A new start is coming. Okay. Gaining momentum. All right. This is what it's saying right here. Good fortune. Invite the magic in. Group number one. I can't reiterate any more about this new relationship, this new love, soulmate, twin flame energy that is coming in. I mean, that it's really just telling you that to just go for it. Embrace it. Accept it. You know, love it. No pun intended, but love that new relationship that's coming in. Okay, I'm going to put these over here, And now I'm going to grab my Enchanted Map Oracle deck for group number one with the same new love. Alright, group number one, new love, soulmate, twin flame, whichever label you want to use. Alright, that's way too many cards. No, I'm not feeling those. Okay. I want one more with it. Okay. Whatever you say. All right. We have Heal the Ouch. That goes with that Eight of Swords. Flying. I feel that that's like with the moon. You're flying high. Emotions are running high. Flying. Okay. Sad Embrace. This is where I'm saying right here with this Eight of Swords energy. Don't let this energy, you know, infiltrate with this new soulmate twin flame connection that's coming in. You have Ghostlands. Again, with the Eight of Swords, don't let the past of bad things come in, because this new love you got coming in is just right on point. It's popping like popcorn. All right. Storm Fields. Like I said, don't let this right here, okay, overpower all this good that's coming in. Where it says with the good fortune, and when it says with the new beginnings, okay. And I know it can be difficult, trust me. I know that when you have a relationship and it's going really, really well, that sometimes you think, oh gosh, what's going on? Is this for real? And then sometimes these old emotions might come in, group number one. But just remember that emotions are running high and things, and that you got this good fortune with this new relationship coming in. So don't let the past hold you back with all these right here. Alright, now let's move to my Priestess of Light Oracle deck. Let me see what it says about group number one, Love of My Dreams reading. Like I said, soulmate, twin flame, whichever label you want to use. That's one. Okay, and we're going to take this one because that one's hurting my hand as well. Okay, we have Earth Magic, Fearlessness, Removing Obstacles. It's like I was saying right here when I was saying the answers are on your way. Emotions are running high. Like I said, the new love is coming in. Time to take action. So that's that Earth Magic right here. Telepathy, Transmission, Perception, Communication. I had the card right here where it says communication is key. Is it just reiterating? I'll end up with communication, that this is important with this relationship as well, to always communicate and keep those lines of communication open. All right, and then we have Balance, Stability, Standing Firm. I know I had a card in here somewhere about balance, but it's in here. It's saying that stability and standing firm, that this relationship will give you balance. Here it is, Messenger with the Starseed, when it says bringing harmony and balance. So we have right here, reiterates the balance. Okay, and we have this card right here, innovation, new creation. Like I said, the answers to your questions are coming. Emotions are running high. I had a good fortune. A new start is coming. New creations. All right. So this is just telling you, group number one, that the relationship that you have coming in for a soulmate is new. It's fresh. Don't let these old ones mess with your mind. Okay. All right, now we are coming to the end of your reading, so I'm going to pull out one of my favorite oracle decks, and that is the Oracle of the Fairies. I'm going to see what they have to say in regards to group number one with your new love. Okay. Let's see what the fairies have to say, because I always feel like the fairy magic, and I love these. Let's see what they have to say about group number one, new love, twin flame, soulmate. All right. Are you going to say anything? Is there anything? Thank you. And this one turned up as well. Okay. All right. I'll put you right here. Okay, we have fairy spotting. We have, it's time to go fairy spotting. It said that seeing is believing, but in fact, the opposite is true, believing and seeing. And it's just reiterating that with this new relationship, believe it, trust in it, that it is real. Okay, ask for help. Angels are celestial beings who protect everyone. And the fairies say, now is the time for you to ask for angelic assistance. I had that card in here where it said help. It's under all these cards right here. But that's just reiterating to ask for help, that relationship that you're having. Temptation. It says, are you in denial about an unhealthy habit, perhaps when it makes you feel guilty? This fairy says you have the power to overcome temptation, whatever is guys. This is just telling me right here, to reiterate that Eight of Swords energy, to don't let, even though it can be tempting, to don't let this Eight of Swords energy creep into this new abundant relationship that you're having, group number one, because I feel like this is just going to be wonderful. Okay, I'm seeing all positive cards. Only thing when I see things come in, just telling you that don't let the past bad people, you know, come in and mess up what is new and good coming your way. So if you ever feel like that doubt is coming in, take a deep cleansing breath and just relax. Okay, because I do feel, a group number one, that this relationship, whether twin flame, soulmate, whichever way you want to address it, is good, yet good for you. But like I always say, when it comes to romance, you know, I'm not a relationship coach, but you know, I feel pretty good with this one right here, with all these positive cards, that it's going to be great. But like I always say, you know, you just use your own judgment and just go for it. All right, group number one, that is the end of your reading. That went pretty fast, but I hope that you enjoyed this reading as much as I enjoyed delivering it to you. I think this is a super, super reading. I'm so proud of you, group number one, that you're finally getting that love in that you want. All right, with that being said, I will see y'all later, group number one. Now on to group number two. All right, group number two, this is your card with the lovers from the Light Seers Tarot deck. And we are asking the question of love of my dreams waiting, whether it's soulmate or twin flame, however the wording of the label you want to use. But this is saying the love of your dreams, how is this going to work? All right, okay, so let's start with the energy of group number two. Let's see how it goes with that. There'll be no reversals. So let's see what the Oracle of the Seven Energies has to say about group number two and the love of their dreams. All right, whether soulmate, twin flame, whichever label you feel comfortable using. All right, let's do it. We have a tall tale and we have a higher leap. Now, normally, when you see a tall tale with this oracle deck, it's like someone's talking about a lot of things might come out of their mouth that could be a lot of okay, then you have a higher view. But with this right here, I'm seeing a tall tale. I'm not seeing that. I'm seeing kind of like, okay, with Pinocchio, if you know the story of Pinocchio, he was a boy that wished to be a real boy. Okay, what I'm seeing with this is it's kind of like group number two, you have a wish of having the higher relationship, okay, higher view. What I mean by that is, it's kind of like you want that happily ever after. And I feel that group number two, with the love of your dreams, it's going to be a happy ever after. So like with group number one, I felt was very positive. With group number two, yeah, I feel like it's positive. That's what I'm saying like this. It's kind of like when, if you watched the movie and he was wishing upon a star, you had Jiminy Cricket break down that song and everything. I feel that group number two, that's what you're wishing or manifesting for, is that you have that higher love. That was a song. Higher love. Okay. Yeah. So that's what it is. Group number two, you want that higher love. You're manifesting higher love, which means that you could have been in relationships. And so that with the love of your dreams, you want a higher, more upstanding love. I think that's the great way of saying it. It's like you want that kind of love that's just like, we'll say Hallmark, Disney. And if you think about Pinocchio, I think Pinocchio is Disney. So that's what I'm seeing with group number two. All right, let's move to the Modern Witch Tarot deck. And let's see what it says about group number two and the love of my dreams, but love of your dreams, because it's readings for you. All right. Let's see what Modern Witch Tarot has to say for group number two. Okay, we have Six of Wands. I should get one more. I'm gonna get the this one too, because that one fell. And then this one. Okay. And then we have Nine of Cups, which, wow. Okay. If you look at group number one, they got the Eight of Swords and Nine of Cups as well, but they didn't get the Six of Wands. Okay. With the Six of Wands, Wand energy is all about building. And if you look right here, it has a V for victory. All right. So what I'm feeling is right here is that with this Eight of Swords, this is where you're coming from when you want that higher love, because you've been through some battles with the previous love and you want a higher perspective. You want higher heights with your love. And what it's saying is that you are building on that. If you see this, the Six of Wands energy, you're coming in with victory with this. And if you see the little ribbons, and I cannot think, oh, I said a little wreath right here. And you see how you have the green blooming on these wands? It's like it's with the manifestations. You're blooming into the new things of relationships that you want. When you get to that, then you have your Nine of Cups, which will be you're one cup away from your complete wish fulfillment. So you are on your way, and you just want that higher level. You're elevating yourself with that, all right? Okay, group number two. Now let's move to your Starseed Oracle deck, and let's see what they say about group number two and your love of your dreams. Group number two, whether it be soulmate, twin flame, whichever label you want to use. I saw you too. Thank you. All right, we have Hierith, longing for home, homesick for the stars. We had the Void, stop, embrace winter, great cosmic moon. And then we have Inner Earth, you'll survive this, new solutions and beginnings, which is what I'm saying right here with the Nine of Cups energy. All right, Hierith, longing for home, homesick for the stars. This is what I'm saying when he made that song, When You Wish Upon a Star. This is just reiterating. And I was saying, longing for home, homesick for the star. You're wishing for a higher love, okay? The Void, stop, embrace winter, great cosmic womb. This is where I'm seeing that universe is hearing your manifestations of you wanting that love of your dream that you want, okay? That you want to be higher, that you could get love, but you want it higher. You want that kind of love, that if I'm not that one-sided love. And trust me, I know what that is too. So don't feel bad, group number two, if you're in sometimes relationships where you feel that you're in a one-sided love, and that's sometimes when you give and the other person takes, but there's no balance, okay? It's just like you give and they're right here. It's like that you're giving them all the gas and oil and you're going empty and their tank is filling up, okay? All right, so group number two, let's go with next. We have the Moonology cards. All right, Moonology, let's see what they have to say about group number two and the love of your dreams. We have, it's time to take action. Got that in group number one, two. A new start is coming. We got that in group number, no, I'm sorry. We got that in group number one. New start is coming. We got in group number one. And then don't let pride get in your way. All right. What this is saying right here. Some people can say, oh, you know, when you want this kind of relationship, that you're reaching too hard. You need to, you know, why are you aiming so high? Don't listen to these people. Don't let pride get in your way. Sometimes people don't want to see you necessarily happy when it comes to relationships. Don't ask me why. It's just the way things are. But what this is saying and telling me is, just because other people feel that you shouldn't have that higher love, don't let the pride of trying, you know, don't let it get in your way. Because it's saying it's time to take action. You do your manifestation to get that higher love that you want, because a new start is coming, group number two. So this does tell me right here that the love of your dreams, it is coming, starting new, okay, starting fresh. That's what group number one said as well. So if you want to take a gander at group number one, you can if you want to, but you don't have to. All right, now let's move to our other cards, my Mystical Wisdom Oracle deck. I'm running out of room. My Mystical Wisdom Oracle deck. This is a new deck that I got for the holidays. Let's see what they have to say about deck number two, In Love of Your Dreams. And what does it say? Group number two, Twinflame, Soulmate. Okay, all right. Fine. All right, choices. Make the best choices. What I say? Confrontation. Pick your battles wisely. What did I just say? Knowledge. Seek knowledge. Potential. Think big for your future. What did I just say to y'all, group number two? What did I just say? I just said, don't let pride get in your way. Think big. Just because people tell you to don't think big about what you want in a relationship, don't you think about it. You think big because it's potential, all right? Choices. Make the best choices. You know what you want. Don't let anyone tell you what you don't want. Don't let the past, the, you know what you want and what you need. Pick your battles wisely. Like I said, you got naysayers. You don't have the energy to deal with them. If they want to be negative, let them be negative. Knowledge. Seek knowledge. What it's saying is you know that you know that you know that you know. Okay? You know what you want. Knowledge. Knowledge is power. Okay? All right, group number two. Now, let's move to the Oracle of the Map Oracle deck. And let's see what they have to say, group number two, about your love of your dreams. Whether it is soulmate or twin flame, which level, it's a bunch of labels, but you know, we're just gonna go for it. All right, let's see what they say. Okay, that's one. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna take those because those were. We'll take this one too, because it did lay on the table. It flew off. Spirit of place. We have strength, field of dreams, and gentle gardener. Okay, like I said again, and I keep saying this, spirit of place. The spirit is within you of what you want. You know. You have the inner knowing. Strength. Keep going. Field of dreams. What'd I say? Think big. Future. Dream big. Field of dreams. Gentle gardener. When you look at this. Okay. When you have your field of dreams, what are you doing? You are gardening what you want. You are feeding what you want. You are manifesting what you want, group number two. So I'm telling you what I'm telling you. In fact, I'm not telling you. I'm telling you the tarot's telling you. I'm just telling you what you need to know. Okay. All right, group number two. Now let's move to the Priestess of Light Oracle deck. And we'll be coming near the end of your reading once we finish with the fairies. All right, Priestess of Light Oracle deck, group number two. Let's see what they have to say about the love of your dreams. Number two, love of your dreams. Group number two. We get one more. Love of your dreams, twin flame, soulmate. Group number two. Thank you. All right. We have circle of eternal joy, timelessness, dance of life. What am I saying? What did I tell you? Portal, infinite mind, awakened consciousness. This was in group number one, but was with the Starseed card. Okay, it's opening doors, new potentials. We've seen with this one. Divine feminine, magnetic receptive power. And I'll be doggone, look at that. Divine feminine and divine masculine, your balance. What did I tell you? I could have sworn I saw something here about balance somewhere. New stories coming. I might didn't, but the point is, this is showing the balance of what you're doing for group number two. That you will have someone to balance. Look right here. This is where we see a higher view. When a bird is flying, he has to be balancing his wings in order to soar. Divine feminine, and divine masculine. It's just showing you the balance that you'll have, okay, to get that view, because that's what you want. You want high vibration. All right, group number two, we are coming near the end of your reading, and I'm going to ask the fairies, what the love of your dreams, soulmate, twin flame, whichever label you want to use, for group number two. See what the fairies have to say. And get one more. Thanks. Appreciate it. Okay. We have abundance. We have look in a book. And we have believe in magic. What did I say? Believe in magic. Open your eyes and see the magic that's all around in nature. The fairy of Northern Light says you are part of nature, so you are magical too. What did I say right here with wishing? With the story of Pinocchio. That's divine masculine. When you wish upon a star. That's magic. Manifestation. Manifesting. Look in a book. Whatever you question right now, you'll find the answer in the book. The words you find will bring you insight. Hey, if you want to read the story of Pinocchio, go have at it. He kept wishing to be a real boy. And even though he went through some obstacles and trials and some things, he got his wish. Okay? I hope y'all have heard that story. And I didn't ruin it for you. But anyway, abundance. Prepare yourself for incoming abundance. Release any mental blocks. What I say about that? Eight of Swords. You may have in fairyland and human land, there is enough abundance for everyone. So what this is telling you right here, get away with the mental blocks. What are people trying to tell you? Naysayers and so on and so forth. You will be abundant with this relationship because you are manifesting something higher. Your vibration wants to be higher, because with a relationship that's higher in vibration, it brings, it gives and takes, it keeps what? You balance. Okay, group number two. All right, I hope you enjoyed this reading as much as I enjoyed delivering it to you. I hope it helps. Like I tell everybody, when it comes to relationships, readings that I give, I'm not a relationship coach or everything, but I'm saying, if this pertains to you, that's fantastic. If it's not, please choose another group. But I love you, appreciate y'all listening, and I'll see y'all later on to group number three. Bye. All right, group number three, you chose the lovers from the Gilded Tarot Royale tarot deck. And the question that we're asking today is the love of your dreams. Well, love of my dreams, but love of your dreams, whether it's soulmate or twin flame, whichever label you go with. All right, we're going to start with the Oracle of the Seven Energies to give you kind of like a general energy of the love of your dreams. And then we'll go from there. Like I said, there's going to be no reversals. So let's just, okay, expose and revealed. All right, let's get one more. Thank you. And we have Beyond the Ordinary. All right, expose and revealed and Beyond the Ordinary. Expose and reveal. Okay. I wish I had my glasses right here. If you look, to me, the eyes are always the windows of the soul. When I look in people's eyes, sometimes I can see things. I'm an eye person, I don't know. But it's like you can see sometimes something in them, whether good or bad. You know, everyone, you know, it's one of those things. And then Beyond the Ordinary. So group number three, what I'm seeing when it says the love of your dreams, I'm seeing that it's something. It's interesting because it's kind of like correlating with groups number one and two, but different. It's like, how can I say this without making y'all think that it's weird? I get that song in my head, I'm looking for a new love, baby. I can't remember, and I grew up with the song. Beyond the Ordinary, Exposed and Revealed is like it's saying you're looking for a new love that's kind of like going to bring out the best in you. Like with myself, when you're looking for relationships, you want someone that can kind of like motivate you to expose and reveal yourself as well. And that beyond the ordinary, okay? It sounds crazy, But it's kind of like with the love of the dream that you want. You want someone that can give you like that pep talk. That kind of like, hey, you can do it. You can go beyond the ordinary. Because everyone doesn't always, you can be supportive. But sometimes you need someone like, hey, come on, let's get up. We got to go. We got to go do this. So I think with group number three, that's what you're looking for. But let me see from the Modern Witch Tarot deck. They want to say about group number three and the love of your dreams. All right. But I think that you're looking for someone that's going to help bring out the best in you. Pull it out of you. You know, you need some motivation. Which, hey, everybody needs motivation. So that's a good thing. All right. You all want a cheerleader. That's one. Oh, okay. Let's get one more. Can I get one more? Thank you. Potatoes. Okay. We have the Magician and a Wheel of Fortune. Okay. So this is what I'm seeing right here. Like I said, you want someone who's going to bring out the magic within you. You know, whatever you're doing. They're going to, you see how you got the infinity sign right here. They want you to be number one. They want you to strive for the best. They want you to be, you want that person that the love of your dreams, you want them to, or they will be, you want them to, they will be. It's just that they're going to pull all the essence out of you, okay? With the Wheel of Fortune right here, that's telling me that it's going to finally be in your favor, because sometimes you might have group number three people who just want to do the opposite and kind of like have you down under the wheel, like down with the gum and the dirt and the muck and the mire, you know, things like that. But I feel that with group number three, because it's kind of like a two-way sentiment, and that's with all three groups. It's like the love of your dreams is what you're looking for, and the love of the person that will be for you, okay? So I feel that that's with it right there, okay? All right. That they're going to be, they're going to bring the magic out of you, and that it'll be like you're fortunate. You're like, ha, finally. The things are finally going in my favor with someone that believes in me and wants to be my cheerleader. All right. Okay, now let's move to the Starseed Oracle deck. And let's see what it has to say about group number three and the love of the dreams. Okay. Way too many cards. Let's try this again. We'll take those. I'm gonna get one more. Right here. All right, we have the Seeds of Mintaka, seeing potential, bringing unconsciousness to the light. What did I say? Jump in. Andromedon energy. Adventure. Say yes to change. Lost land. Soul memories and gifts. You've done this before. Like I said, soulmate, twin flame. I don't even have to explain this right here, but I will. Bringing potential. You want someone to bring out your potential. You want someone to be your cheerleader. Jump in. Andromedon energy. Adventure. Say yes to change. Yeah, I want to change, and I want you to help me change, because we're in this together. Soul memories and gifts. Like I said, soulmate, twin flame. You've been together before, okay? All right. Love that. Okay. Let's now, got chills. Let's move to the Moonology. Let's see what Moonology has to say about group number three and the love of your dreams. Okay. Let's see here. I'm going to put you right there. There we go. We have Nothing is yet set in stone. Okay, but that is mutable moon. You and your loved ones are safe. Okay, your commitment is being tested. Okay, so what is it telling me? Group number three, that is saying that nothing is yet set in stone. So what it's saying is that you've got that potential to come out. So just because you're in a situation that you're in now, you got moons for improvement to have everything that's good with your new love to help you, motivate you. You and your loved ones are safe. If some of you in group number three are worried about loved ones and things, don't worry because you're fine. I know I had those thoughts too about if you're safe and everything that's going on. And it's just saying, yeah, you're good. Just rest. Get some of these things off your mind, okay? Your commitment is being tested. Ah, now, what does that mean? Same thing with me. When I manifest all these different things that I want out of life, my commitment is always being tested because the universe wants to know, okay, if I give this to you, you're going to have to go through the things to get to where it is. How committed are you? Okay, so with group number three, it's the same that if you want this person, they can pull everything out. You got to be committed and you got to say, okay, because universe will give it to you, but you got to say, hey, okay, universe, I trust you. You know what you're doing. So that's what it's saying. Your commitment is being tested. So if it's taking a little bit longer, group number three, than what you think it is, I got to tell myself this too. Just keep going and we'll get there. All right. Okay, now let's go to the Mystical Wisdom Oracle deck. And like I said, my other groups, this was given to me as a Christmas present. So I love this new Oracle deck. So you won't see me like bend it too far because I'm that kind of person. Alright, let's see what they have to say about group number three. And the love of their dreams, soulmate, twinflame. Okay, put you back over here. We have friendship, nurture your relationships. Ha ha ha. Angel of miracles, open your heart and expect a miracle. And we have children. Know that your children are protected. So again, if you are saying with you and your loved ones, it's reiterating that you're still fine. Just quit stressing about it. Okay? Friendship. Nurture your relationships. It's telling you that the relationship that you're coming into, it'll be a tight friendship. But when you get that higher, because they're going to be like a cheerleader and a friend for you. Angel of miracles. Open your heart and expect a miracle. That's what I was saying with right here. Your commitment is being tested. And with the magician and with the jump in, it's saying open your heart because it's saying and say yes to change because open your heart to expect a miracle, saying yes to change. Okay, that's why right here, because if you're ready for it, it's gonna come in there. All right, now let's do the Oracle of the Map. Oracle deck. Let's see group number three. What does it say about the love of your dreams? It says soulmate, twin flame, whichever label you want to use. Let's see what the Oracle of the Map has to say. Okay. Thank you. I'm going to do one more for. Thank you. Appreciate it. One Ring Circus. Slow and steady, protecting treasure. Alright, so we're saying right here, you always have slow and steady wins the race. When you are manifesting and you want that higher up, you want to be slow and steady. You don't want, you know, it's coming in slow and steady, but it's going to win the race. Look here when it says the One Ring Circus. I feel that with the One Ring Circus, it's kind of like it goes round and round and round. Excuse me. But it's saying that, I feel like the back of my cards right here, look at here, back here, when things are going in circles, that, you know, it's kind of like, okay, the momentum, like we on a, I think like maybe like a roller coaster, and when it goes around, that ring of fire, that's what it is, that ring of fire, and it's gaining momentum. So it's like, okay, you got slow and steady, but One Ring Circus is gaining momentum, so that the relationship is coming in, what you want, the higher heights, that is coming in, okay? And, you know, things might be going around and around and around, but don't worry, because, like, again, it's saying, protecting your treasure, that, again, group number three, if you're still stressed about being protected, it's the third time, you're protected. So, group number three, if you're worrying about that, please stop worrying, because it keeps popping up. But like I was saying, Slow and steady wins the race. One ring circus, because I hear that song, Circus. Is that by Britney? I can't remember. But it's saying, but me here, I see it's a good thing because it's kind of like, okay, I can. When the person is building you up with the higher relationship that you want, it's kind of like, okay, I can hold my own too. When you have that one ring circus, I'm seeing that as well, because it's kind of like, okay, you gave me the motivation that if I need to do things on my own, I can too. So that love of your dreams, I feel it after a while, slow and steady. Ah, that's what it is. That by and by, when they pull and help you, that you'll be able to stand on your own, and that they'll still give you encouragement, but that you have the confidence that you can be your one person. Like, you know, I'm with you, but I can handle this too myself. So that's what it is, group number three. Okay. All right. Now let's go to the Priestess of Light Oracle deck, and let's see what it has to say, group number three, about the love of your dreams, whether, like I said, soulmate, twin flame. Let's see what they have to say about you, group number three. I saw you. Thank you. Thank you. Let's get one more. Okay, we'll take them. I'm not being picky. Whatever you say. We have summoning power, instinct, intellect, control. That's that one ring circus I was telling you about, slow and steady. Hostility is conflict and unrest. That's what I was saying again with this, the thoughts that you're having when you're unrest. Stop worrying so much about you're good, okay? Just take a deep cleansing breath, all right? Harvest, gathering of blessings. That's what I'm saying, because you got blessings and things coming, so relax, you're okay. Loss, lack, fear, victimization. So, okay, group number three. I'm getting two different kinds of messages from you. All right, hidden knowledge, a shaky records and silent understanding, and then also shamanic journey, purpose, attunement, and vision quest. Okay, this is your vision right here, because you want to go higher above in your relationship. But I'm also seeing something else too. Number three is saying that, and then with the silent understanding, that's where it's right here with the, come on, with the exposed and revealed, is that as you come out in the relationship, so on and so forth, that you are being more presented out to people, and the gatherings of blessings. Like I said, you're having blessings coming to you, and the summoning power, instant intellect, and control. That's with that slow and steady, that one man circus. But these two things keep popping up: fear and victimization, and loss, lack, hostilities, conflict, and unrest. Group number three. Like I said, this might not pertain to everybody in group number three, but if there's one person, maybe to however many people it could be, and trust me when I tell you this, I deal with this too, that you have this fear and anxiety, and you can't, it's like a lot of times you can shake it, but sometimes it's on you like a bad shirt that's just wet from rain, and you're trying to just get it off of you. It's like mud being stuck on you. It just takes your time, and also if it's that slow and steady. It can also mean with this too, it's going to take time, slow and steady, but just take one day at a time. I had to listen to and just take one day at a time. Don't think about tomorrow, and don't think about yesterday. Just think for today, and that's what helps me, because sometimes my brain, it'll go, and I'll think 4 months, 5 months, 6 months ahead, a year, 2 years, and so I had to listen to other fellow readers, because I listen to readers too. So yeah, that take one day at a time, because that helps my anxiety. Okay, because when you have that fear and everything, and it's just your unrest, that it can just mess up everything with your manifestation. I'm not saying no, your manifestation is not gonna be messed up, but you know, having a clear understanding and concentrating. Okay, so like I'm saying, this is two messages for group number three. Whatever the fear and things that you're having, and constant fear, just take one day at a time. And then with here, also, if you want that relationship to reach that higher level, have that person pull that potential out of you, that could be your fear too. But the same, rest assured that you are okay. All right, that's the Priestess of Light Oracle deck. Now we're coming, wow, to the end of your reading. And I'm getting ready to draw out the fairies of the fairy oracles. Oracle cards, and see what the fairies have to say about the love of your dreams, whether soulmate or, my goodness, twin flame, whichever label you want to use. Let's see what they say. Thank you. We have believe in magic. Like a song, do you believe in magic? Open your eyes and see the magic that all around you in nature. The fairy of the northern lights say you are part of nature and you are magical too. That's what I'm saying right here. Went ahead beyond the ordinary and expose and reveal. Okay? Find balance. Find a balance between your work, rest, and playtime, and you'll have more energy, harmony, and productivity in your life. So if you want to take a power nap, that's going to help you. Dear group number three, with finding balance, because sometimes with all these, and I'm seeing all these thoughts and things and stresses that you're having, take just a good nap. There's nothing wrong with a nap. Naps are a wonderful thing, and sometimes when you take a nap, your body shuts down, and it can help get downloads and, you know, things like that. And then when you wake up, you have a fresh perspective. And that's going for the ones who's having a lot of anxiety, okay, going on too. That also goes for the ones who I want that manifesting that relationship to be higher. It all coincides with y'all. It'd be both messages. Alright, group number three. But all in all, I think it's a very good message. This is just telling you that if you got some fears and things, what to do. Just be calm. If you gotta listen to some meditation music, take a hot shower, take a hot bath, whatever you have to do, eat you a good meal. Sometimes food is just soothing to me. So anyway, but with that being said, group number three, I hope you enjoyed this message as much as I enjoy delivering it to you. I hope it helps. I hope it motivates you. That with that love of your dream that's coming in, I hope that it helps. And like I said, I love your message for you. I'll see you another day.